Hello, welcome to the QuickerSim CFD Toolbox for Matlab tutorial 21. In this tutorial, we will show you how to perform an unsteady simulation of free convection between differentially heated plates. So, let's have a look at the geometry first. That's a fluid confined between two walls and with symmetry boundary conditions on side. That means that the flow can slip on this wall. Those are no-slip walls. And in the part of those walls, the fluid is being heated on the top and cooled on the bottom. When it comes to the thermal boundary conditions, that's insulation on 13 and 14. The hot top has the temperature of 20 degrees Celsius, while the cold one has more or less 0 degrees. The working medium will have the viscosity of water, 1 times 10 to the minus 6, but much lower thermal parameters, that means lower density, lower thermal conductivity, and specific heat. Also, we need to define the thermal expansion coefficient, which is the inverse of the reference temperature, 283 kelvins, and beta, 1 over 283 kelvins, and define the gravity that drives the flow. We'll be using the Boussinesq approximation, since the simulation is incompressible, and we need to model the buoyancy force that results from slight temperature variations. Let's have a look at the geometry first. Obviously, it's really simple. Just two plates with the zones that are denoted differently in those places. But that's just a rectangle. Okay, so most things are straightforward. We convert mesh to the second order. Then we define the properties of the fluid. We initialize the solution. We are obviously interested in the temperature field as well, so we define the T array, and we also define temperatures in the lower and upper part. We obviously give the temperatures in kelvins, but actually here it wouldn't make any difference if it's Celsius or kelvins, because the flow is incompressible. That's for post-processing. Here we define the time step. We'll perform very few steps in the simulation just to speed it up here. After that, we assemble mass matrices, since this is an unsteady problem. And we also want to shoot the movie when the simulation continues, so we define the movie object's quality, resolution, and open the object. So let's initialize everything, and then let's proceed to the iterative loop. Okay, so we perform n time steps. Each time we define the time, sample Navier-Stokes matrix, which is pretty standard. Now we introduce the Boussinesq buoyancy force, zeros on x direction and minus g beta temperature difference in y direction. We add this force field as assembled vector source term to D and zeros further on. We add unsteady terms to the problem, and we impose the boundary conditions. So there are no slip walls that are horizontal and slip along y, which is the vertical wall. And then we solve for velocity in a standard way. After that, we solve the unsteady heat convection problem. So we multiply the temperature mass matrix by T, and we assemble diffusion matrix with constant heat conductivity, and we add the convective part due to velocity, and we add up those two matrices. After that, we can apply the thermal boundary conditions. Actually, we just apply the temperature in 11 and 12, and 13 and 14 walls are not defined, so that means that they are isolated. After that, we just visualize the solution. So generate figure, display that, and provide extra parameters for writing the movie, calculate velocity magnitude, and prepare yet another frame for the second movie, display time step. And after the iterative process is finished, we just close the movie. So let's have I look at how it performs. And there we go. you can see that temperature decreases on the top and increases on the bottom, while the velocity currents start to form. This is a pretty coarse mesh, so we will not have nice results, but then we will show you how it performs on a better mesh. So the movies that were generated before on a better mesh look the following. That's the velocity magnitude in the simulation. You can see the vortices forming in here, the slip boundary condition present on the side, and circulation of flow is beginning over here. And such a nice double vortex develops here. When it comes to the temperature, it looks the following. Hot fluid on the bottom, cold on the top, starts to flow down. And yeah, the vortex develops and starts to convect the flow. You can see that the thermal diffusivity of this fluid is pretty large because the cold currents dissipate pretty fast. Okay, so that's all that we wanted to show in this simulation. We hope that you enjoyed. If so, please download the toolbox, visit our website quickersim.com, and see you next time.